Good afternoon and happy homecoming. Tim Stubbs, glad to be with you once again here from the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff. Your UAPB Golden Lions set to take on the Bulldogs of Alabama A&M. It is homecoming here at UAPB, and as you can hear in my voice, I have been sick pretty much all week with either bronchitis, laryngitis, one of the itises. This is about as good as it's going to get for me today, so please bear with my very weak voice, and I apologize to our listeners today, but I will do the best that I can. The visiting Bulldogs come in, and they're going to kick it off here in their road whites and their maroon pants. UAPB in their home blacks and gold accents. Golden Lions 1-4, 1-2 in SWAC play. Alabama A&M 1-5 and 1-4 in conference play. Opening kickoff's a short one taken from the 24-yard line and a pretty good return over the 35 up to about the, let's see where they're going to spot him down, I believe around the 36, maybe 37, maybe a little bit better than that actually. They're still yet to mark the football. We're going to call it officially at about the 39-yard line. So that's how we start the game. Homecoming here, and we have a huge crowd on hand here in Pine Bluff. And what's turned out to be a beautiful day. Not too hot, not too cold, and we've still got fans filing in. The Golden Lions will have the football here to start the game. First and 10. Three receivers right. They're going to throw it left, and it's going to be Willie Young. Third leading receiver in the SWAC makes the catch at about the 45-yard line. A gain of about six, maybe seven on the play. They'll give him the 46. So that's where we are. Cody Swain and Willie Young, the Louisiana Lightning connection, if you will. One's from Baton Rouge, and Swain and Young is from New Orleans, Louisiana. Both seniors and both third ranked in receiving in the conference. Duncan takes the snap, looks right, is going to dump it off to Swain, and he's eaten up immediately as he's going to lose yardage back at about the 43-yard line, and that's a loss of about three on the play, so it's going to bring up third down and six here for UAPB. 1 minute in, just underway here. Partly cloudy day, but it has given way to the sun here at kickoff. Here on this third and six, showing pressure are the Bulldogs. Looking to blitz off the edge. They hit Duncan hard and he's sacked. Sacked back at the 35-yard line, and the Golden Lions are going to have to punt it. And he was hit blindsided hard there for a big Bulldog sack on third and six. And the Golden Lions will have to punt it here on 4th and 13. So Jamie Gillen comes on to punt. It's been doing a fantastic job. Last game averaged about 46 yards a kick, including one of 70 yards in that game. He'll get a chance to show off his leg here. High snap, has to back up, kicks it rugby style. Gets off a pretty decent kick. Going to be taking the fair catch at the 24-yard line. And that's how the Bulldogs will start their first possession. And a good job of Gillen there. I'm not sure if it was designed to kick it rugby style. That's how he learned to kick. His dad, a rugby player, and obviously picking up that trait as well. He can kick traditional style very well also, but that time caught it, had to back up while he was catching it, and took a couple of steps to his left and got off a pretty good boot there. So the Bulldogs will take over. D'Angelo Ballard, the quarterback. They fake the end around, going to throw it deep here on first down. Post over the middle, and it's caught. Big gainer, and it's punched out. And the Golden Lions are not going to be able to get it. Punched out by Braxton Hoof. As he tried to jump on it before it went out of bounds, he would have had a fumble recovery, but lost it out of bounds, and the Bulldogs catch a huge break as they're going to have a first and 10 at the Golden Lion 29-yard line. They fake the end around and go deep with the post. Ballard connects for a huge gain, But then Hoof made a nice recovery, punched it out from behind. But there is a flag on the play. Did not see it. Flag on the play, which is going to negate the big play nevertheless. So I said the Bulldogs caught a break, in which they did initially. But now the break was going to go UAPB's way, as there was an illegal man downfield, which happens sometimes on these trick plays. So the Bulldogs, that will negate a huge gain of about 50 yards. Instead, now they're backed up at their own 19 instead of having the football at the UAPB 29. Ballard's going to go deep again. He's got a man wide open, taken down at the 49-yard line, and a huge gain of 30 yards. So Alabama A&M coming out and going deep back-to-back plays. That was Tevin McKenzie, their senior receiver for Mobile, Alabama. 12-24 and counting. Opening quarter here, homecoming, 2016. No score. Alabama A&M, this is their first possession. The Golden Lions had to punt on theirs. First and 10, ball spotted right at midfield. Ballard going to throw it again. Got McKenzie again. He's tackled immediately at about the 42-yard line. Gain of about 7 on the play. Well, spotted at the 43. Needs to get to the 40 for a first. The starting running back in the backfield is Jordan Bentley, but he has yet to get a carry. Three straight pass plays for the Bulldogs. They'll fake it to Bentley, and the pass is incomplete, trying to slip it to their tight end, Jonathan Dorsey, but the pass was off the mark, and to bring up third and 3 for Ballard and the Bulldogs. Stops the clock at 11:30. Here in the first, no score. Three receivers to the left here for the Bulldogs. Ballard set for the snap, sprints right with it, and he's not going to get to the edge. He's going to lose yardage. Back at the 47-yard line, a late flag has come in after the play. And Monty Coleman is living on the sideline, and this appears to go against UAPB. This is as big as a turnover. An outstanding tackle on the edge by Tashad Charity. But a flag was thrown after the play.
After the play, unfortunate conduct from the 51 of defense, 15 yards.
And they called it on Charity, who made the play, and maybe just getting up with exuberance, maybe over-celebrated the play, but they call a personal foul penalty instead of it being fourth down, and the Bulldogs punting it, potentially. It's an automatic first down for Alabama A&M, and that's a huge play early on. And those have been the type of plays that Coach Monty Coleman's been harping on that are the difference makers in a win and a loss. Ballard takes the snap from the 34. Quick strike is caught, wrestling for yardage at about the 26. And a gain of 6 on the play. That's Dorsey, the tight end, again. Second down and 4 coming up. Gonna run it finally. 15, 10, still on his feet, a little cut back. Dorsey dives for the end zone. What an effort. Touchdown, Alabama A&M. What an effort. Quarterback keeper, design run, weaved his way through the left side of the field, and a couple of sweet moves at the 10 and then 5, and then dove for the pylon, and the Bulldogs strike first with 10:15. Play, as for our TV viewers, can't see the last number there on the clock, but there's a block on the extra point. And it's booted and out of bounds. It's going to go for no score there. The Golden Lions could have scooped it up and had a chance. But 10:15 to play. We'll step aside here for a timeout. 10:15 to go first quarter. It's Alabama A&M 6, UAPB nothing. The Golden Lions will receive the football when we come back.
When some people struggle with their mortgage payments, they become frozen, petrified. Not knowing what to do, they do nothing. But the people who do something, the people who take action, are far more likely to get the most positive outcome. Making Home Affordable is a free government program. Call now to talk one-on-one with a housing expert about the options that are right for you. Real help, real answers, right now.
Don't let E. coli mosh with your food. An estimated 3,000 Americans die from a foodborne illness each year. You can't see these microbes, but they might be there. So always separate raw meat from vegetables. Keep your family safe at foodsafety.gov.
Back inside of Golden Lion Stadium, Bulldogs up 6-0. Their opening possession. Quarterback Ballard took it in from 24 yards out for the score. They're set to kick it away here. See if the Golden Lions can get something going. Taking it from the 22 and trying to get to the edge. We're not going to get there. Maybe the 28-yard line. That's about it. A gain of 6 on the play. So UAPB offense, who have been very dominant in the air early on here in the season, see if they can get it going again. But it's going to have to start with the offensive line up front and that ground game to free up some of those pass plays, because they're coming hard and heavy on Brandon Duncan, which was evident on that last drive as he was blindside blasted for a big loss on the play. A little pistol formation here, two to the left. Montgomery, high snap, they fake it to him, quick strike over the middle, and the big tight end's got it wrestled backwards, but they're going to give him forward progress at about the 35. And a gain of 7 on the first down play. As number 23, Cameron Williams. Williams, 6'5", 250-pound junior out of North Little Rock, Arkansas. Played there for the Charging Wildcats in North Little Rock. And their primary target, along with Collins, at the tight end. They'll hand it off here. Fighting for yardage was Montgomery. Not getting a lot. Drug one man for a yard. And that's about it. Bring up third and short. With 9.5 to go here in the first. 6-0 Alabama A&M. But the big extra point block could come back to loom large later in the game. Swain's in motion from right to left. Looking left, throwing, tipped and incomplete. Well defended, in and out of the hands. That ball had some heat on it. And the Golden Lions are going to be forced to punt it. With 9:10 to go, and missed opportunity there, but Brandon Duncan had some heat on that ball as it went through the hands of Willie Young, the intended receiver, but he had a man blanketing all over him, and Gillen's on for his second punt of the first quarter here early on. Good snap this time, more traditional kick. It's off a pretty good one. Return man's going to watch it go out of bounds. That was Rashad Anderson, the deep man there on the punt return. 9:02 to play here in the first. 6-0 Alabama A&M. With the lead. Sponsors of Golden Lion Athletics for the 2016 season are Arkansas Lottery, Brown Funeral Home, Coca-Cola, Energy, Nike, Reliance Bank, RJ's Grill, Russell Athletic, Sissy's Log Cabin, and Trotter Ford Lincoln. Ballard takes the snap. Bentley's got it. Nice cut back at the 30. Still on his feet. Finally taken down over the 40 up to the 44. So they came out in the air the first series. Now they come out on the ground for their second series here. That time Bentley was able to get something going. So far the Bulldogs having their way. Golden Lions going to have to make some adjustments. As Ballard was set for the snap and quickly now looks over to the sideline, maybe changing plays. Play clock is down to 8. Fullback in motion. They'll snap it to him here. Hand off Bentley again, hard running. Spins off one man and finally taken down into the Goat Lion territory at about the 48-yard line. That was Scotty Peace, a senior strong safety from Oxford, North Carolina, on the stop for the Golden Lions. You'll hear names of Peace and Hoof from the safety spot here today for the Golden Lions. Ballard still in that pistol, two wide left, one right. Now a little three-step drop. It's over the middle, caught at the 20, at the 10. Dorsey fights for the end zone, going to be drugged down at about the one-yard line. First and goal for the Bulldogs, and they have come out dialing it up deep here this afternoon. And he was wide open, the big tight end on a post route right over the middle. And that was just a little pistol formation, three-step drop, and bang. And the Bulldogs looking to go up by two scores here, first and goal. They'll go no huddle. Hand off, Bentley, right side, touchdown, Bulldogs. 7:23 to play, first quarter, and Alabama A&M, they have showed up in a bad attitude, and they don't care that it's homecoming. They're up 12-0 here midway through the first quarter. As we have some cloud cover now, as the sun will exit for a moment. First extra point was blocked by the Golden Lions. We'll see if they can do it again here. Got a hand on it. It was partially blocked, but it's good anyway. So we'll step aside. 7:23 to play. First quarter here from homecoming. 13-0 Alabama A&M. Trying to play spoiler for the UAPB Golden Lions today. Right back with the kickoff in just a moment.
Hey, Hard, what's this?
That's my resignation letter.
You're resigning.
Why? Because you're constantly ignoring me. You're half as active as you used to be, and you get stuff like this. You've been putting me under a lot of pressure lately. That's why I'm ready to quit.
I forgot. I'll do better. Please, don't quit on me.
Okay, but remember, it's not what you say. It's what you do.
Listen to your heart. Don't let it quit on you.
Let's go for a walk.
Uncontrolled high blood pressure could lead to a stroke, heart attack, or death. Get yours to a healthy range before it's too late.
Back inside of Golden Lions Stadium here, 7:23 to play. First quarter, homecoming. But so far, it's been the Bulldogs who have come out and punched UAPB right in the mouth, 13-0. 7:23 to go in the first. Now the Suns is back out. Here's the kickoff coming up in another short one. Taken from the 19 here. Nice cutback, little stutter move. Peterson, 30, 35. Flag comes in late here as Peterson got up to about the 38. And that's in the area of usually a hold or a block in the back and could negate good field position, but penalties. And it is going to be on the Golden Lions. So UAPB. 2-3 and outs offensively to start this game. In Alabama A&M, all they've done is score twice on both of their possessions. It's 13-0. 13-0 Alabama A&M. Little misdirection in around here by Swain. They'll fake the handoff now, just having to keep it. Like he wanted to hand it off to McDonald there, but decided to keep it, and he's going to be taken down. Duncan's taken down for a loss of about 3 on the play. So, second down and 13 coming up. And the Golden Lions right now not fooling anybody offensively as this Bulldog defense up for the challenge. Kind of hard to believe they're 1-4 in conference play, 1-5 in overall play. Going to throw it here. Duncan steps up in the pocket, may run it. He tucks it at the 30. Big hit as he just lowers the boom on a defensive back. Down at about the 33. A lot of times you see a quarterback sliding, and that's what they're taught to do. Duncan had none of that. Looked like a running back, and then at the end of the play looked like a fullback as he just blasted the would-be tackler there, Dexter Reese. Third down and 2. Gain of 11. Handoff left side. First down. McDonald lowers the shoulder, and the Golden Lions pick up their first down of the game here with 6 minutes to go in the first. Again, Swain, a little end around. They'll hand it off. McDonald, right side's got something here. Midfield stays on his feet and tripped up. Tripped up, but not before he ripped off about 16 yards and a first down. UAPB getting it done on the ground now. The best they've looked so far, back-to-back first downs. Run it again. This time, McDonald's belted. Going to lose a yard back at the 47. 5:20 and counting. First quarter. Alabama A&M leading 13-0. Bring up second down and 11. This time it's Hawkins in motion from right to left. Pump the swing pass, got to get rid of it, dumps it off now. Hawkins trying to make something happen, and he's wrapped up at about the 46. Just a gain of 1, but Duncan was going to take a sack there. He wanted to go up the left sideline to Willie Young. It was covered. Reese, the cornerback, was there. So they had to check down to Hawkins, who was the man in motion. Third and 10 here from the Bulldog 46. Duncan looks over to the sideline. Now they're set. The lone back is McDonald. Three receivers right, one to the left. Duncan's going to throw it. Looks right. The pass is high and incomplete. Looking for Swain, but it sailed high on him. And the Golden Lions are forced to punt again. Big crowd on hand here today, and it's been a great homecoming week all week long here at UAPB. Always such a festive week full of so much tradition. Here's the punt. Going to go rugby style here on this one, trying to pin them inside the 10. And it's going to bound just inside about 2 yards into the end zone. Almost perfectly placed. Gillen's very good at doing that, dropping it inside the 10. Sometimes even better, but that time he had just a little too much on it for the touchback. 3:59 to go. Here in the first, been all Alabama A&M so far. They lead it 13-0, looking for more as they have forced UAPB now into 3 punts. The Golden Lions looked better on that last drive, picked up a couple of first downs, but nevertheless finishes with a punt. Hand off this time straight ahead up to about the 22, and that is it for running back Harvey Harris. Harris is a junior from Montgomery, Alabama, 5'10", 170. He spells Bentley to start this series. 3 receiver look. They have gone to that deep post play and connected a couple of times here in the first quarter. Ballard over the middle, trying to squeeze one in there and somehow making the catch as his helmet gets blasted off. He's going to have to come out for a play. That was Odarius Williams making a really nice, high concentrated catch. Took a big hit and his helmet got knocked off, and I don't know how he caught that. Gain of about 6, maybe 7. Call it 3rd down and 3 coming up here for Alabama A&M. They fake the handoff. Ballard's going to run it himself. A little pump fake. Got the first and more up the left sideline and out of bounds at the 37. He was going to run it all along, but he did a little pump fake just to get Scotty Peace in the air. Peace bit on the fake. He was about the only man that could have stopped him for the first. A nifty little play there by quarterback D'Angelo Ballard. Ballard out of Macon, Mississippi, a senior. Not a big guy, only 6'1", 200. Hand off this time straight ahead and nothing there. The Golden Lions stack it up the middle. So no gain on the play. That was Harvey Harris again on the carry. 2nd down and 10 coming up. Approaching 2-minute mark here in the first, 13-0. Alabama A&M as the sun is back out and blasting here at Golden Lion Stadium. Handed off again. Harris breaks one tackle, fighting for extra yards. Gets up to the 45. It'll bring up 3rd down and 2. Gain of about 8 there. That was some hard running for Harris. First man in there on the stop. John Tavis Testa, freshman linebacker out of Miami, Florida. Coral Gables High School put out a lot of great players over the years. 3rd and 2. Sprinting right. Ballard got McKenzie caught at the 50 for a first. As we approach the 1-minute mark in a fast-moving first quarter of action. Spotted at about the 49 of A&M, but enough for a first down for the Bulldogs. 1:10 to play here in the first, 13-0. Alabama A&M playing a near-perfect first quarter of play. This is their 3rd possession. They scored on their first 2 possessions while forcing the Golden Lions to punt 3 times. You can't ask for a better start than that. They'll hand it off. Harris again. Stacked up to Shad Charity in there on the stop for the Golden Lions. Gain of just maybe 1 yard or 2 to the 49 of UAPB. Maybe 1 play left in the quarter here. ...25 seconds counting. Tight end in motion. They'll fake the handoff, sprinting left. Here's Ballard again. Got a lead blocker up the left sideline and another first down. Out of bounds at the 33-yard line. I mentioned only 6'1", 200 pounds, and he's basically a running back playing at quarterback position, which was very evident on his first touchdown of the game, which was a nice run. 6 seconds left, and that should end the first quarter of play. You're listening to Golden Lion football right here on Hot 89.7 and watching it right here on UAPB TV. The end of quarter number 1 here at homecoming. Alabama A&M 13, UAPB nothing. 2nd quarter coming up in just a moment.
As an 18-year-old, I let my mistakes kind of take over my life. I was 0.5 credits away from completing high school and I didn't do it. When I found out that I was pregnant, I know that I had to do something for myself if I wanted to make her a better person and provide a better life for her. My family never stopped pushing for me to be better because they knew what I could become and who I could become as a person. my support team is amazing. The educational director here, my sister, and even my 7-year-old daughter has just been more than the support that I could ask for.
And to see you makes me proud.
I've been given an opportunity, and I'm just thankful for it.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
Welcome back inside of Golden Lion Stadium. Tim Stubbs here, homecoming. Happy homecoming 2016 here at UAPB. But so far it's been all Bulldogs. Alabama A&M leading 13-0 as we are set to start quarter number two. The Bulldogs driving again here. Hit as he throws it and incomplete. Closest man there was Dave White, cornerback for UAPB, as Ballard had to get rid of it. He was under a heavy rush that time, and he was actually hit as he delivered the football, and Ballard did a good job of just getting rid of it where nobody could get it. Second down and 10 coming up. But Ballard has had a great start to this game. D'Angelo Ballard, the senior quarterback. Quick strike left, caught. One-on-one out here and just hanging on for dear life at the 20. Picking up the first down for the Bulldogs was number 19, O'Darius Williams, on the coverage and the stop that time for UAPB. Jabryson Justin, junior out of Lauderdale Lake, Florida, made the stop, and he wrapped up Williams that time, and it was just hanging on, but he held on and made the tackle. So the ball at the 20, first and 10 for the Bulldogs, already leading 13-0. Design run to the left, got a block, and just enough, just a piece there, and knocked out of bounds. Good job there on the edge. Gentrell Woodard getting just a piece of Ballard and knocking him off balance, only a gain of a yard. Bring up second down and 9. Really fast moving first quarter. Stay tuned for halftime for our TV viewers. Have a great battle of the bands as Alabama A&M is here as well. Should be a great show for halftime. Gonna throw it here. Got a man talking about wide open. It doesn't get any more wide open than that. Touchdown Bulldogs. Are you kidding me? That's a busted assignment, to say the least, as he could have. He had literally all day there to throw the ball with a man wide open, nobody within about 15 yards of him. Good gracious. Marcel Clash. And another Bulldog touchdown. My. So it's been all Bulldogs early on here. Extra point is good. So we'll step aside again. 13:50 to go. Second quarter. Alabama A&M 20. Golden Lions nothing. Golden Lions going to have to dig out of a big hole here. And we'll see if they're up for the challenge. A lot of game left here at homecoming. Back in a moment.
Me sentí mal porque miré que todos estaban graduando a mis amigos y yo no me iba a graduar y sentía que la escuela no era para mí. Pero hace un año fui a México con mi mamá. Miré muchas cosas que me hizo cambiar mi mentalidad. Cuando regresé, mi educación fue la primera cosa que quería terminar porque sentí como que si quiero cambiar el mundo, tengo que cambiar a mí primero.
Quiero dar gracias a todos que están aquí, porque sin ellos no hubiera estado donde estoy ahorita.
Muchas felicidades, mija, y te quiero mucho.
Y mi consejera, ella fue lo máximo para mí, porque me ayudó mucho con todo.
Muchas gracias por la consejera, que la ayudó bastante. Si no, no hubiera podido graduar.
Puse mi cabeza en mi educación y lo hice.
Encuentra clases gratis de educación para adultos cerca de ti en completatudiploma.org.
Daisy is 6 years old, and she is my very best friend. I couldn't live alone without her. I spend a lot of time in my backyard. I feed the birds and the bees. I love my flowers. The color in my garden keeps the pink of my cheeks. I was very independent and thought I could take care of myself. I fell and I had to have Meals on Wheels. I love them. They're my savior. And I look forward to volunteers because they've all become my friends. My name is Lola Silvestri. America, let's do lunch.
1 in 6 seniors faces the threat of hunger, and millions more live in isolation. Drop off a hot meal and say a quick hello. Volunteer by donating your lunch break at americaletsdolunch.org.
Bulldogs set to punt it, or to kick it off here, rather. 13:50 to go. Second quarter, and it's been all Alabama A&M here in the first half. 20-0. The Golden Lions have been forced to punt on every possession, and Alabama A&M has scored on all three of their possessions. And you just couldn't draw up a better start for the visiting Bulldogs. At the angry Golden Lions are going to have to dig deep here and come from behind again. Kickoff taken from the 13-yard line up over the 20 and driving hard for extra yards at about the 27. That was Keyshawn Williams, the sophomore out of Pine Bluff, Dalloway. Saw a lot of Keyshawn last year. Haven't seen as much this season. He had a really nice freshman year. Made a lot of nice things happen with the football, but been primarily on the kickoff unit. The Golden Lions got to find something to go. This is a big possession here. Need to come down and score and get back in this game. Trailing 20-0. They'll take over first and 10 at their own 27. Duncan wants to go left. They set up a screen and defended pretty well. Only gets up to about the 30-yard line. A gain of 3 on the play. That was John Hawkins on the grab. So bring up 2nd down and 7. Showing blitz, and they'll pick it up and take him down again. Too many men in the box, not enough players to block them, and the Bulldogs get to Duncan once again. Loss on the play of about 4, maybe 5. Gonna bring up 3rd and 12. Tried to fake the handoff, and the Bulldogs were coming hard. So 3rd down and 12 here. Showing blitz again off the right side. Scrambling to his right. Gonna run it. Not gonna get much. Hit hard at the 25-yard line. No gain on the play, so it's not a sack. But it's gonna be another punt for UAPB. Jamie Gillen has been very busy. And this is gonna be his 4th punt. 4 possessions, 4 punts. Alabama A&M's had 3 possessions and scored all 3 times. I mean, you're talking polar opposites of success here. They're bringing pressure, and it's going to be taken. Fair catch at the 45. So Alabama A&M will get good field position. Already leading 20-0 with 11:53 to play. They'll take over in charge of this game right now. Sponsors of Golden Lion Athletics, Arkansas Lottery, Brown Funeral Home, Coca-Cola, Energy, Nike, Reliance Bank, RJ's Grill, Russell Athletic, Sissy's Log Cabin, and Trotter Ford Lincoln, all proud sponsors of Golden Lions Athletics 2016 season. Gonna throw it. I don't know how he got it off, but it's caught at the 50. Still fighting for yardage, and gonna bounce him back at about the 49 of A&M. Gain of 4 on the play coming through there for the Golden Lions. That was number 50, Ja'Kevin Carter. And Carter looked like he had a clean shot on Ballard, but missed him. Able to get the pass off nevertheless. So it'll be second down and 6. Gain of 4 there on first down. Ballard, handoff, Bentley, huge hole still on his feet, secondary, foot race, 20, 10, taken down at the 5, and a flag comes in at the tail end, maybe a face mask. Dave White saving a touchdown, doing all he can, but a huge run by Jordan Bentley, freshman from Gunnersville, Alabama. He was trying to house that one. Dave White caught him from behind, but in doing so, grabbed his face mask. Be half the distance to the goal tacked on. And Alabama A&M just having their way with UAPB here in this first half. First and goal from the 3. Here's the snap, a high one to Ballard. He's going to keep it himself. Foot race for the corner of the end zone. He's not going to get there and slides down at the 5 and loses. 2 on the play, coming hard on the edge. That time for UAPB was Tashad Charity. He had Braxton Hoof over there as well. But Charity did a nice job, good closing speed there for the junior defensive end out of Norfolk, Virginia. Second down and goal from the 6. They actually lost 3 on the play. McKenzie in motion. They'll fake it to him. Ballard's going to keep it. Ballard's going to score. Touchdown, Alabama A&M. And they look like a well-oiled machine coming in here. Blowing up UAPB's homecoming right now in the first half with 10-12 to play. Second quarter, still an eternity left in this game. It's 26-0 Alabama A&M. They have scored on all 4 of their possessions, and defensively right now, Alabama A&M having their way with the Golden Lions. Extra point is good. We'll step aside. 10-12 to go. Second quarter, Alabama A&M 27. UAPB nothing. The Golden Lions will receive it when we come back after this timeout.
I see you mobbing over her. Let's go. Let's mob. Let's crawl. Let's crawl. Let's crawl. Hey yo, we mobbing. Come on, girl. Let's crawl. Hey yo, let's crawl. Hey yo, let's crawl. Hey, let's crawl. Hey yo, let's crawl.
Right, mi cariño. So like I said, everything I learned about cooking, I learned from grandma's empanadas. Shall we go again?
Yep.
Mix beef with the onions with the peppers with the paprika, the garlic with the oregano with the cumin. Got it?
Got it.
Throw on the olive, stir, season, stir again, pour out the flour, roll out the dough, make a circle, drop in a fistful of filling, fold over, press down, and ta-da!
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day making sure they brush is easier, and it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain.
You've messed up your son's haircut.
Mom?
Do you A, try to fix it?
Like it never happened.
B, work with what you got? Or C, show solidarity?
Thank you, baby.
As a parent, there are no perfect answers. But you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
Did you know dragging chains can spark a wildfire?
Only you can prevent wildfires.
10 minutes, 12 seconds left here, second quarter. It's been all Alabama A&M so far, as they lead it 27-0 over the Golden Lions. Each team with four possessions. Alabama A&M forcing four UAPB punts, and the Bulldogs have scored on all four of their first half possessions. The only thing they haven't done right is have an extra point blocked. That's about it. Short kickoff going to be taken by Williams from the 12. Keyshawn at the 20. Hits the edge at the 30. Nice little cut back and out of bounds at about the 35, maybe the 36. Gain of 24 on the return there. Best field position so far by the Golden Lions. Start a throw on 36-yard line. So UAPB will take over. 10:04 to go, second quarter, in desperate need of a score. Bulldogs showing pressure again, getting rid of it this time. Hawkins got it at the 40, 45, and taken down hard at about the 47. And gained right at 10, and a first down for the Golden Lions. As the sun is blasted through the clouds once again. And it's a beautiful day, but there are still a lot of clouds here, so sun's going to pop in and out throughout the afternoon. Going to throw it here, Duncan. Over the middle, got a man, complete. Willie Young, gain of about 9 on the play. Up to the 44-yard line, we'll call it the 43, rather. And they're going to give him a gain of 10, just enough for the first. So back-to-back first down pass plays. The Golden Lions playing with a sense of urgency here. Hand off. Hard running by McDonald to the 38-yard line. Gain of about 5. .905 to go before halftime. 27-0 right now. Alabama A&M in control. Having a huge first half. Hand off McDonald. Hard running. Keep those legs churning close to first down yardage. It appears to be enough. Let's see where they spot the football at. It is enough. So three straight first downs here in a matter of four plays. The best the Golden Lions have looked. Did get pretty good field position starting at their own 36. Now they're at the 33-yard line of Alabama A&M. Willie Young in motion. Goes behind the quarterback. They'll toss it to him. Gets a block, trying to get to the edge. Not going to get a lot to the 31-yard line. That's about it, a gain of 2. Bring up second down and 8. Set for the snap. Looks right, under pressure, trying to get rid of it. He will not. He's sacked. Sacked all the way back at the 46-yard line in a huge loss. Loss of 14 on the play. That'll leave you shaking your head for sure right there. Boy, that's tough loss of 14. You go from second down and 8 to third down and 22. Ouch. They'll snap it here on third and 22. Dump it off. Little screen to Willie Young. Young at the 40. Looks for a block. Trying to get outside. He won't do it. Almost needed about one more block to spring him. Got up to the 36-yard line, and the Golden Lions may go for this here. Gonna go for it. Fourth down and about 13. Ball spotted at the 36 of Alabama A&M. Four receivers set. McDonald, the lone back just to the right of Duncan. Set for the snap here. Looks left, throws left, picked off. Or is it incomplete? It's incomplete, almost intercepted. So a turnover on downs. Alabama A&M is going to get it back. So the Bulldogs right now just can't do anything wrong. They come in 1-5 in conference play, and you just look at that and shake your head at that record. Right now they look like they're leading the SWAC. This is the best performance we've seen so far by a SWAC opponent against UAPB, as they are playing lights out here this afternoon. .620 to go for halftime. 27-0 Alabama A&M. Here's Bentley this time, left side. Bounces off of Charity, still on his feet, up to the 45, a gain of about 9 on the carry, and turned a 3-yard gain into a gain of 9. Hard running by Jordan Bentley. And what a, you gotta love the name Jordan Bentley. That sounds like a running back. Well, Bentley that time was running like a truck. A minute ago he was running like a Bentley as he broke free in the open field. But that time he was a truck and picked up 9, but man down on the field for the Bulldogs. I have a injury timeout here. We'll step aside with them. 5:59 to go. Second quarter. 27-0 Alabama A&M with the lead. We have an injury timeout. Back more in just a moment.
Here we go. Here we go. We're going to go out there in the rain. Going to get wet. All right, here we go. Oh, look at the rain. Okay, good. Oh, yeah. Yes. So much fun.
It takes less than 1 minute to find out if you may have prediabetes. You can do it here. But you probably won't. You're busy. Kids, work. Show coming back in 48 seconds. So let's do this now. Hold up one finger if you're a man. Women, 0. 3 more fingers if you're over 60. 2 over 50, 1 over 40. If you're not sure, keep in mind you're sitting on a couch right now, so 1 more finger if you're not very active. 1 finger if yes, 0 if no. 1 yes, 0 no. Next, find the body type that looks most like you and hold up that many fingers while I look around awkwardly. And that's it. If you're holding up 5 fingers or more, you probably have prediabetes. Sorry to be so blunt, but hey, you're busy. Just go to the site.
Are your children in the right car seat for their age and size? Is the seat supposed to be forward-facing or rear-facing? Did they move to a booster seat too soon? It may be too late to check when you're on the road. Fortunately, you're on the couch. Car crashes are a leading killer of children 1 to 13. Don't think you know. Know you know.
Back inside of Golden Lion Stadium, still during an injury timeout. Alabama A&M has an offensive lineman that has been down for some time now. Full medical attention from trainers, staff for both teams. Out on the field now, slowly getting up. That's a good sign. It's always scary to see young man on the field that long. That was Derek Isaac, 6'4", 260-pound offensive lineman, a senior out of Macomb, Mississippi, will slowly walk to his own sideline, but good sign there to see him up on his own power. So 5:59 left here before halftime, and Alabama A&M leading 27-0 over UAPB here at homecoming. And the Bulldogs just coming in like gangbusters here in the first half. Can do no wrong. They've scored on all four of their possessions. Pump fake here. Ballard going to throw it. Got a man open. Diving catch, but he couldn't hang on. Tried to go to Dorsey, his big tight end. He had it for a moment, but as he hit the ground, it popped out. Bring up third down and two. They can afford to take that shot downfield on second and short, because you know if you don't have it, you still got third and short to run the ball if you want to do so. So good play call there by Alabama A&M. Makes sense. They're set here. Going to run it. Short gain. I don't know if he got it. I don't think he did. He's going to be short. Gave it to Bentley again, but this time he was hit immediately. And the Bulldogs can either go for it on fourth and one or punt it for the first time today, and it looks like they're going to go for it. So they will go for it. This would have been their first punt opportunity, but on fourth and one, and see if they're going to maybe try to get UAPB to jump off sides here. Ballard is set, goal line showing blitz, and a flag has come in. This may be a false start, and it is. Now they're going to punt it. Is that'll make it fourth and six. So it end up backfiring on them. So a false start penalty. First punt of the game coming up here, bringing some pressure. Not a very good kick, caught on the fly, and Roland caught a fair catch and then was hit after it, and flag's going to come in for interference, catch interference here. The UAPB's going to get some yardage out of this. They caught it at about the 31. So the Gold Lions would get a little bit of a break here. It was a low line drive kick. And the would-be tackler, I don't know if he saw the fair catch. It happened so fast. So the Gold Lions are going to get it at their own 45. Had a good drive going on their last drive. End up turning it over on downs at the 36-yard line of Alabama A&M. We'll see if they can get something going here. Only 4:28 left before halftime, and it's 27-0. Bulldogs with the big lead. Going to throw it here over the middle. Caught. That's Cody Swain. Swain's got a gain of about nine up to the 46-yard line of A&M. Well, it's second down and one. Clock rolls right at 4 minutes left before halftime. They'll snap it. Hand off. It's Terry Montgomery this time. Montgomery maybe loses a yard, wrapped up in the backfield. First man in there for the Bulldogs. That was number 52, Kenneth Davis. Junior linebacker out of Pensacola, Florida. So now third and two after losing a yard. No huddle attack. He'll hand it off. McDonald, right side, running hard. See if, I think he's got the first if they give him a good spot here. He didn't have much, but they gave him a pretty good spot. Forward progress gives the Gold Lions a first down. Hard running, Dante McDonald. That's what the 230-pound back can do for you, is he can ground and pound and get those tough, hard yards on third and short just like that. Swain in motion. They'll snap it, set up a screen. Now they're going to have to get rid of it. Duncan throws it and then into the crowd. If it's arena football, they get a gift. But it's not. Got to get the football back. But this big homecoming crowd got more than they bargained for. And pretty good catch there in the crowd. Right on the sideline, a good throwback. .251 to play. Before halftime, 27-0. Our score, Alabama A&M over UAPB. Golden Lions faced with a second out and 10. At the Bulldog 44-yard line. Now they're going to call intentional grounding. They waited and talked about it. Now they're going to call intentional grounding. So that's going to back the Golden Lions up. All the way back at their own 40. That's a big play. And Monty Coleman, head coach, is not happy about it. Talking it over with the officials. Trying to. Now another flag is thrown on the sideline. And this is going to be a sideline warning. So it's just they throw the penalty flag, but it's actually a warning. The Golden Lions not happy with that intentional grounding call. Now you're looking at about second down at Christmas. I mean, it's second 25. 2:51 to play here before halftime. Big battle of the bands coming up at halftime. Alabama A&M has made the trip with their band, of course, the marching musical machine of the Mid-South. One of the baddest bands on the planet. Set to entertain this big homecoming crowd at halftime. So stay tuned for that. Should be very exciting. Not a lot to cheer about for the Golden Lions here in the first half, trailing 27-0 here at homecoming, but they're in tune or in store for a big halftime treat for sure. Still a lot of game left. UAPB has definitely shown signs of coming back. They'll have to do so today. They'll dump it off here to Swain at the 40-45, midfield, and up to about the 48 of Alabama A&M. Picks up about half of that yardage back from the penalty. So 2:32 left. Not enough for the first, so Jamie Gillen's going to come on and punt it away, and Alabama A&M's going to call a timeout here. So they call a timeout. They want the football back. They're greedy like that, those Bulldogs. They're up 27-0, and they are not through. They want to get it back and score again. 2:25 to go before halftime. They still got two timeouts in their back pocket. And they say 27's not enough. Let's keep it rolling. But UAPB's going to have something to say about that. Head coach for A&M, James Spady. Golden Lions going to have their work cut out for them, then some. They want to come back here in this one. They've had a couple of nice comebacks already this year, but this one would definitely top those comebacks for sure. Gillen set to punt it for the fifth time. Deep man for the Bulldogs is Rashawn Anderson. He's back deep. It's going to be a fake. Gillen, 50-45. Gillen's got the first, I believe. A fake punt was called. Gillen running hard. It's going to depend on the spot. I thought he had the first down. It's a questionable spot right by the sideline of UAPB. It looked like he went out of bounds right at the marker, but they're going to call him a yard shy. My goodness. And now another flag has come in, and Monty Coleman is just beside himself. He's telling his players to back up. This is the second warning, so this may be a penalty. sideline warning. But I thought Jamie Gillen got the first. They called him out at the 35 and needed the 34-yard line, but an outstanding effort on the fake punt and a great call by the Golden Lions there. But he ends up being a yard shy, but Gillen made a great effort. But just come up a yard shy. I'd like to see that one again if we could, but I thought it was a poor spot. And I thought he had enough for the first, but apparently not. So 2:16 left. The Bulldogs will get it back at their own 35, leading 27-0.
Sideline warning. On Pine Bluff point bench with a dead ball.
So, going to be a sideline warning again, but the second one, you get a 5-yard penalty for it. And that's what's just happened. So the Bulldogs are already up 27-0. Looking for more here. Stepping up in the pocket. Trying to get by one man, not able to get by Charity. Tashad Charity stepped up there, only a gain of one. Ballard was just about to break free. Tripped up by Charity for a gain of one at the 41. Under 2 minutes to go. Still two timeouts left for Alabama A&M. Second down and nine. Their own 41. Movement, no call. UAPB bringing pressure. Ballard going to go deep. Up the right side, incomplete. Battling for it, and a late flag has come in at the 20-yard line. Shufan Alcorn was in coverage, and he was tied up with Ladarian Heath, a big 6'4", 200-pound wide receiver from Phenix City, Alabama. At that time, they're going to get Charity, I believe, for pass interference, or check that, Shufan Alcorn, rather, for pass interference.
Two fouls. An
eligible man downfield against the Bulldogs. No offset. So 1:41 left. Penalties will offset. Stops the clock there. Replay the down, second down and nine, as if it didn't happen. Was a legal man downfield for Alabama A&M, and for Arkansas Pine Bluff was pass interference, but penalties offset. Replay it here. Here's the snap. Ballard under pressure, rolls to his right, throws on the run, caught by Dorsey, the tight end at the Golden Lion 39. What a grab. And he's slow to get up as he took a hit and it hit the ground hard. But he is shaken up on the play right near the Alabama A&M sideline. 1:33 left before halftime, and it's going to be an injury timeout here, but we're going to keep it here as he is. Looks like he's going to be all right. So this will be a short timeout. So like I said, we'll keep it here. Next up for the Golden Lions, next Saturday, we'll be heading to Baton Rouge down to southern Louisiana. Golden Lions taking on a very good southern team. That's 4 p.m. next Saturday. We'll have that for you right here on Hot 89.7. And back-to-back Louisiana swing as the Golden Lions will take on Grambling State from Grambling, Louisiana, the following week on the 29th of October. That's a 2 p.m. kick for that one. Before returning home November the 5th against Mississippi Valley State, 2:30 kick for that. At Texas Southern on the 12th of November, then wrap up with Prairie View A&M here at 2:30, kickoff on the 19th. Here we go. First down, pass play incomplete, trying to dump it off to his back, Bentley, coming out of the backfield, but overthrew his intended receiver. Dead quarterback D'Angelo Ballard. So bring up second down and 10 from the goal line, 38. 1:24 left before halftime. It's been all Bulldogs here in the first half. A&M leading 27-0. Pistol formation for Ballard. Takes the snap. Looks left under pressure. Throws man wide open. Caught at the 25. Hit hard right there, but enough for a Bulldog first down. Clock will stop momentarily while they move the chains. That was Monte Jones, another big receiver, 6'4", 200 pounds, out of Cleveland, Ohio. At the 25, Bulldogs knocking on the door. Played a near-perfect first half so far. Looks right. Ballard, all day to throw it. In trouble, flushed out of the pocket. Near the sideline, just throws it away. Threw it in the area of Monte Jones, but about a yard or two into the ground in front of Jones. Stops the clock at 1:02. So Alabama A&M faced with a second down and 10 from the Golden Lion 25. Still two timeouts left and leading 27-0. Quick strike, left side, caught at the 20-yard line. Only a gain of 5. That was Monte Jones again. Bring up third down and 5. The clock continues to run. They may call a timeout, and they will. So Alabama A&M calls a timeout. We'll keep it here. This will be a short timeout. If you're just joining us and you're wondering who that broadcaster is you're listening to, well, it's me, Tim Stubbs, and I know I don't sound like myself, and I apologize. I know I'm sick of listening to myself in my headset, so I can imagine you probably are at home or in the car, wherever you may be. So pardon my voice here this afternoon, as I've been battling some sickness this week, and my voice decided to take a vacation on me. Here as we approach the homecoming game, and a couple of days ago it went out altogether, and it's slowly been coming back the last couple of days, so apologize for that, but all is good and battling through it. So it is me, if you're wondering, or if you APB got a new broadcasters, don't get too happy, it is still me. 27-0, our score. It's homecoming. Huge crowd, great weather. Been a great week, but it hadn't been a good first half. 27-0, all Bulldogs here trying to spoil it for the Golden Lions. Going to throw it here, almost picked off. Braxton Hoof broke on it at the 10, and he banged into the receiver. Ball's incomplete, or he would have had a pick right there. He broke on that brilliantly. Braxton's really come on this year. Free safety out of Camden, Arkansas. 6'1", 215, good size, good player, Braxton. Almost had him a pick right there. So the Bulldogs going to attempt a field goal from the left hash here. It's going to be a 36-yard attempt for Nick Carden. Carden's kick is up. It is long enough. And the kick is good. And again, I said they couldn't do anything wrong. Well, they just keep it going. It's 30-0. Alabama A&M on a 36-yard field goal by Nick Carden. We're going to step aside here with 41 seconds left before halftime. Alabama A&M 30, UAPB nothing. Kickoff coming back in just a moment.
Look at you. You're at the top of your game. You're unstoppable. Nothing can throw you off track.
Wait, is that your car?
Uh-oh. Yeah, I saw that coming.
That will throw you off track. You're looking at around 10 grand in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Let's try this again.
Smart move.
Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
All right, I know this isn't any fun to talk about, but we should. Okay, so who's gonna do what?
I'll pack the dead batteries.
Great.
I'll only put what I don't need into a duffel bag.
Perfect. That's totally unhelpful.
No problem.
Meanwhile, I will try to comfort everyone by speaking in a calm voice.
And I'll try to get the generator going without any gas.
Oh, let's not forget the cell phones, which probably won't work.
Right.
And who is going to handle supplies?
I can forget to do a list for us.
Thanks, pal.
Well, I think we couldn't be any less prepared. I'm proud of you guys.
Talk to your kids about who to call, where to meet, what to pack. Visit ready.gov/kids for tips and information.
Looks like it's done.
Don't let salmonella get funky with your chicken. On average, 1 in 6 Americans will get a foodborne illness this year. You can't see these microbes, but they might be there. So learn the right temperature to cook each type of meat. Keep your family safe at foodsafety.gov.
Just 41 seconds left. Here before halftime. And it's all Alabama A&M, 30-0. As they are set to kick it away after a Nick Carden 36-yard field goal a moment ago. Here's a little short pooch kick. Going to be taken by an up back at the 26. Over the 30, up to the 35, maybe the 36-yard line. Golden Lions will take over there with 32 seconds left before halftime. UAPB does have 3 timeouts. If they want to try to do something, but this has been a tough first half for the Golden Lions, probably their worst half of the season. And you sure hate that it would come at homecoming out of all games in front of this big crowd. But it is what it is. Alabama A&M bringing in a late substitution here. Going to throw it. Duncan steps up in the pocket. Nowhere to go with it. Now he's going to run it. 35. Slung hard out of bounds. That's a personal foul. That's big. It's going to be 15 yards added on the end of this run, which took Duncan out of bounds at the 41. That's going to put UAPB into Bulldog territory now. Still with 3 timeouts left and 22 seconds. So a silly penalty. They called a horse collar tackle, and I haven't seen a lot of those called college football this year. The NFL really cracked down on it because of players getting injured. I've seen some in college football, but I haven't seen it called like they probably should. It's a dangerous way to tackle somebody. You can really hurt somebody pulling them down from the back of their collar. That's why they implemented the rule a few years back. So UAPB's got it at the Bulldog 44. Duncan pressured again, rolls out to the left. Got running room 40, 35, 30. Duncan going to dive down at about the 26 with 13 seconds left. They can call a timeout here. So they use one of their 3 timeouts with 13 seconds left and still a couple of timeouts to see if the Golden Lions maybe take a shot or two at the end zone. Stops the clock at 13 seconds and the ball spotted at the Bulldog 27. This is as deep as the Golden Lions have been in Bulldog territory this afternoon here in the first half. As the battle of the bands about to go down at halftime. M4 and visiting Bulldog band in the house. Alabama A&M's band will go first, and then the M4 will show them how it's done right after that. So Duncan and his crew back on the field here after the timeout. Ball spotted at the Bulldog 27. Three receivers right, one to the left. Montgomery in motion now. He'll go split out wide left. They'll empty out the backfield. Duncan takes his time. Bulldogs looked a little confused on defense as they're trying to move some guys around. 1 second left now. They're going to blow the whistle. The Golden Lions are going to have to waste their second timeout here. That was very peculiar. Coming out of a timeout, they call another timeout before they snap the ball. A little bit of confusion on both sides of the ball, it seemed to be there. Seemed like the Golden Lions confused the A&M defense, and then when they made some adjustments late, it kind of confused the Golden Lions offense, so they didn't like the look. So they take their second timeout. That was a little game within the game there. So Golden Lions now only with one timeout remaining. Like to have seen to see them have kept that timeout if they could. Apparently they could not do anything about it. Didn't want to take a penalty as they that maybe they were changing the play at the last second. So now a four receiver look, three right, one to the left. Terry Montgomery, the lone back. He's just to the left of Brandon Duncan, takes the snap. Duncan steps up in the pocket, running room, 25-20. Duncan at the 10, hard hit at the 7. Call a timeout here with 5.8 seconds left. That's where I was saying you'd like to see them have two timeouts, but that's their third timeout as Duncan made another nice quarterback run there. It'll be first and goal from the 7. We'll call it the 8-yard line maybe. First and goal for the Golden Lions, but they only have maybe possibly just one play left here. Take a shot in the end zone, but if you throw it quick enough and it's incomplete, you can still get another play out of it. Three doesn't do you a whole lot of good. Seven, you'd feel a little bit better about it going into halftime with a touchdown and at least give you a glimmer of hope going into that second half. As UAPB trails Alabama A&M by a score of 30-0 with just under 6 seconds left here before halftime with a first and goal from the 8-yard line for UAPB. So we had a fast-moving first quarter. It's been a much slower second quarter. So here we go. Goal Lions are going to go ahead and not take any chances. They're going to attempt a field goal here. Thought maybe they could get one shot in the end zone, but they're going to go ahead and go for the field goal. It's going to be a 25-yard attempt near the center of the hash marks. Extra point is up, and it is no good. No good. And that's how we end the first half, and it couldn't go any worse for UAPB, and it could not go any better for Alabama A&M. Our score at halftime here on homecoming, Alabama A&M 30, UAPB nothing. We'll step aside now for the Battle of the Bands. Stay tuned for that. Back in a bit.
Oh, look, a redhead.
Staring contest.
You still got it.
I know.
Come alive with the forest.
The dad was cute.
You were looking right at us.
Visit discovertheforest.org to find a forest near you.
When I was 6, I had one thing on my mind. When I was 6, My days were spent playing basketball every chance I could. When I was six, my dream was to make it to the NBA. When I was six, my mom had a stroke.
I'm Paul George, and I want you to learn the signs of a stroke fast. F-A-S-T.
F, face drooping. A, arm weakness. S, speech difficulty. T, time to call 911. Because the sooner they get to the hospital, the sooner they'll get treatment. And that can make a remarkable difference in their recovery.
Protect the ones you love.
Spot a stroke. F-A-S-T. Fast.
Story. Adopt at theshelterpetproject.org.
sweet baby. You mean everything to me. I love you.
Can we get strawberries?
No, honey.
Please?
Okay.
Thank you.
17, but I know about investing. Believe in something, buy shares in it, watch it grow. So, what if you could invest in the future? The future of kids, like a stock. Not the kind of stock that's about making money, but a stock for social change. A whole new kind of investment called Better Futures. When you invest, it helps kids go to college. I could be one of the first college graduates from my family, the first philanthropist from my neighborhood. And if I'm the first, then maybe there's a second and a third. Believe in us, invest in us, watch us grow.
My name is Sydney, and I'm your dividend.
When I was in foster care, I never knew when I would have to move, so I always had my suitcase ready to go. Then one day, I was adopted. My new parents opened their hearts and home to me. My parents cook my favorite breakfast for me every morning. My parents take me on trips I never thought I would go on. They gave me a home and an even better reason to use that suitcase. My parents aren't perfect, but they're perfect for me.
So you see, son, good manners are important. Should I go through it again?
Yes.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Exactly. Always say please, thank you, you're welcome, excuse me, sit up straight, hold doors open for ladies, if the door's locked, knock first, don't burp, don't swear, don't stare, don't use bad language, or talk with your mouth full, keep your elbows off the table.
What table?
Don't interrupt. Cover your mouth when you cough or sneeze. On the bus, give your seat up to anybody who has trouble standing. Bottom line, treat others the way you want to be treated. Got it?
Got it.
Good talk.
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day making sure they brush is easier, and it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain.
Welcome back inside of Golden Lions Stadium. We are set for the second half here, and what a performance by both bands at halftime that we just saw just a moment ago. Opening kickoff's going to go to the Bulldogs. Of course it is. Everything's gone their way. Tim Stubbs, glad to be with you once again here as we start the third quarter. And again, I apologize for my voice. You got to put up with it for two more quarters, folks. Been battling some sickness this week and just want to make it known to our fans listening that I am okay, just going through some stuff with my voice the last few days, so it'll be back to normal soon. But this game, though, what in the world? The first half, 30-0, Alabama A&M. I don't know if anybody saw this coming. The Bulldogs blitzing the Golden Lions here. Here on the first handoff up to the 40-yard line, first play from scrimmage, a gain of four for Alabama A&M. 30-0, our score. I'll get into some halftime stats for you as we move right along here into the second half. Have some big shadows casting out over the stadium and sun-drenched field for the most part in that first half. A second down and six coming up here. Ballard going to throw a quick strike to McKenzie. Alcorn was trying to strip it. McKenzie's got enough for the first down, a gain of about seven. So the Bulldogs will move the chains here. First and 10 for Alabama A&M. Penalty on the play, going to go up top deep, and that's going to be another penalty. This could be two here. Pick your poison for Alabama A&M because I believe UAPB may have jumped off sides. They took a shot deep, and then Braxton Hoof got tangled up with the receiver for Alabama A&M. It's going to be pass interference, so not a good start. So they'll decline the offsides and accept the pass interference, 15 yards on that. So that's how we start the second half. The Bulldogs up 30-0. The Golden Lions had one chance to score their best drive at the end of the first half, but there was a 25-yard field goal missed by Jamie Gillen. That was the last play of the first half, whereas the Bulldogs outgaining UAPB in that first half. I'll get to the stats in a moment. Here's the play. First and 10, rollout pass caught near first down yardage by McKenzie again. It's McKenzie's fourth catch of the game, leading receiver. Catch-wise, leading receiving yardage-wise is Jonathan Dorsey, their big tight end. Three catches for 74 yards. Also had a 47-yard pass play that set up a first and goal for the Bulldogs in that first half. But 327 yards to UAPB's 143 in that first half. Going to throw it here. Pass is incomplete. Alcorn did a nice job of breaking on it. It was intended for Ladarian Heath. But a tough first half for UAPB to say the least. D'Angelo Ballard was 12 of 18 for 175 yards and a touchdown in that first half. He was not sacked, did not throw an interception. Leading rusher was Jordan Bentley for the Bulldogs, six carries, 82 yards, and a touchdown. And D'Angelo Ballard, seven carries for 90, or a total of 58 yards. He had some big sacks. They're trying to go wide with it here and nothing happening. So it's going to quickly bring up third down for the Bulldogs. So it'll be third down and 11 for Alabama A&M here. For the Golden Lions, leading rusher was Dante McDonald, six carries, 34 yards. Brandon Duncan, nine carries. He had 53 yards, but count all the sacks. He was sacked three times, so he only got a net of 23. So a little misleading there. Brandon Duncan was 11 of 15 for 73 yards. No touchdowns, no interceptions. Going to throw it here in trouble. Gets out of problems at the 20-15-10. Ballard down to the 6, first and goal, Alabama A&M. And he's been doing that all game long. I mentioned only 6'1", 200-pound senior quarterback, but he's basically a running back in that position, and you can see why right there. Quick, no huddle. They'll attack here on first and goal from the six. Now they'll look over to the sideline. Hand off Bentley straight ahead, stacked up. Jontrell Woodard was the first man in there. Then they throw him backwards. Got to be careful after the whistle. Don't want to get a personal foul there. As they sling him backwards. Woodard was the first man in there along with Willie Duncan. .11:40 to go. Here in the third, first possession. They'll sprint left with it with Ballard. Looks for a block. He got it. Touchdown, Alabama A&M. Set it up perfectly on the left side. Got a great block on the edge. It goes in untouched for the score. With 11:25 to go here in the third. And to start the third quarter, it's more the same for Alabama A&M. They have scored on all but one possession, I believe, in this game. Up 36-0 now. The extra point coming up. Alabama A&M has come in and put on a clinic here today. They have looked spectacular. The extra point is up, and it's good. So we'll step aside. You're listening to Golden Lion Football, Hot 89.7, and watching it right here. You're home for Golden Lion Sports, UAPB TV. 37-0, Alabama A&M leading UAPB here on homecoming. 11:25 to go, third quarter, back in a moment.
I rescued Toast from a shelter in 2011. I love Toast because she's a lazy diva. Toast does whatever she wants, obviously. She's sleeping right now. She's an epic snuggler. She's so comforting. She's so loving. Toast makes me laugh. When I walked into the shelter, I knew right then that she was special.
Todd's a great guy. I mean, look at him. What a sweetheart. Attaboy. Wait, Todd, what are you doing? How totally selfish and un-Todd-like of you. Come on, Todd. Come on, man.
Here's the kickoff. Again, they just keep kicking short. I'm not sure if he can get it to the end zone, but it doesn't really matter. The Golden Lions can't get great field position. Either way, good coverage by the Bulldogs. They've pretty much been clicking on all facets of the game. 11:17 left, still a lot of game left. But for the Golden Lions, they have dug themselves in maybe an insurmountable hole here. Down 37-0. Got to just keep grinding, keep playing, try to get better each snap. I know that's what the coaching staff's preaching to him. Rolling out to his right, caught by Willie Young at the 25. Gets some extra yardage, five more after the catch to the 30. Appears to be enough for a Golden Lion first down. So that'll move the chains for UAPB. Started to look a little better in that second quarter to the Golden Lions, moving the ball, but still have yet to score in this game. And on the other side of the ball, Alabama A&M is yet to be stopped. A recipe for disaster here. It's UAPB trying to find something, some momentum. Gonna go deep up top where his big tight end had it for a moment and lost on contact. Two number fives fighting for it, Jaron Collins. The big tight end had it for a split second. And defensive back Callaway came over and knocked it loose right as Collins had it for just a second. Pretty well thrown ball and almost executed there. But it falls incomplete, second down and 10. took a shot. Collins caught a long touchdown at Alcorn. Similar to that, a little crossing pattern to Swain. Swain's got it down at the 34. Bring up third down and six. Clock continues to roll here. About 10 and a half minutes left here in the third. Gonna throw it, Duncan under some pressure, cranks it up deep left side and incomplete, looking for Hawkins, and Callaway was right there step for step. Brings up fourth down and Gillen on to punt it away. Dillon was busy in that first half punting the ball. Punted four times, averaged right at 39 yards a kick, and he's shown signs of a better average than that in the last few games, but Alabama A&M just punted just the one time. That was their only possession. They did not score. No pressure, though. Gillen gets it off. Pretty decent kick. Fair catch called. They fumbled it for a moment, but then pounced right on top of it. That was Rashad Anderson, who had to go to a knee to try to catch it, but he was able to jump back on it. So with 10:06 to play here in the third, this juggernaut, if you will, Alabama A&M Bulldog offense will get the ball again. As UAPB's offense hasn't been able to keep them off the field. Now with five punts in the game to just one punt for A&M. And the Bulldogs have not messed around. When they got it, they're making the most of their opportunities. Pretty good field position here. They start at their own 35, 37-0 A&M with the lead. Handoff is going to be Bentley again. Hit first by Kevin Carter and stacked up by a host of Lions. Gain of just a yard for Bentley. So just a gain of one. With this big lead, you may see the Bulldogs keep it on the ground quite a bit here in the second half. Try to eat up this clock as they have the game well in control, up 37-0. 9.5 minutes left here in the third. Their second possession, and Willie Duncan comes in on a blitz. The pass is caught on a little slant. First down up to the 46. Pass was caught by Odarius Williams. Gain of 10 on the play. They take their time. Now Ballard with a man in motion. That's his tight end. Going to hand it off to Bentley. Makes a little move and then he's stuck hard. To Kevin Carter says hello. With a nice square up tackle. No gain on the play. That's how you hit him right there. Carter, 6'1", 225, sophomore out of Ruston, Louisiana. Just a few miles from the Grambling State campus. Roll out here. Ballard goes to his left. Nice move at the 50. First down and more. And finally taken down at the UAPB 43-yard line before Nick Williams, a senior defensive lineman from Forest City, Arkansas, made the stop, but not before another Alabama A&M first down. And the nifty quick Ballard, been doing it all day. First down snap, they'll play action, roll to his right this time, Ballard. In trouble, just trying to get rid of it, and he's able to do so. Got out of the pocket and got it back to the line of scrimmage near the sideline of A&M. Incomplete, bring up second down and 10. Stops the clock at 8 minutes to go here in the third. Second down and 10, set for the snap here. Quick strike out of the backfield to Bentley. He's got it at the 40. Bentley breaks the tackle up to the 30 and a first down. Mark him down at the 29 of UAPB. Just a little swing pass out of the flat there on the right side of the field. So the Bulldogs continue to move the ball at will. No one's got the man in the slot here. That's McKenzie now finally. UAPB sees it, showing blitz. Run it right side, it's Bentley, and gets to the 25-yard line, maybe just shy of the 25. Gain of about 4 on the play. Clock will continue to roll here, 7:15 and counting in the third. Gorgeous afternoon here in Pine Bluff. Everything's set up. Great homecoming week. All culminated by the big football game on Saturday, which is happening right now, but Alabama A&M is not going along with it. A lot of tailgating going on out there in the parking lot, the RV club, and they'll be partying all night long. Little stump off, looked like maybe a running back screen there to Harvey Harris, blown up incomplete. So to bring up fourth down, a rare fourth down here for the Bulldogs, see what they want to do with it. They just go for it if it's too long for a field goal, but too close to punt it. This would be about a 45-yard field goal here, so I think they're just going to go for it. Or check that, maybe third down. So third and 6 instead, my bad. Hand off straight ahead, breaking a tackle. Harris close to first down yardage for the Bulldogs. That was hard running. Harvey Harris, 6:34 and counting. Take their time, play clock down to 7. Snap it here to Ballard, coming in on a blitz. And they finally get to quarterback as Willie Duncan finishes him off. A rare sack, the first sack actually. John Tavis Testa came in first, flushed him out of the pocket. He got a hold of him, and then the all-swack linebacker Willie Duncan comes and finishes Ballard off for a big loss on the play back to the 26-yard line of UAPB. Bring up second down. They can get a first down around the 9. Ballard set for the snap here. Looks left, dumps it off to Harris. Got two men out there waiting on him and played perfectly as he's down at the 29-yard line and he's going to lose about 3 more. Braxton Hoof, Willie Duncan on the stop. .450 to play. Clock continues to roll and down to 10 on the play clock here. Going to be third down and about 20 here for the Bulldogs. They're going to throw it. Ballard got a man wide open and he missed his tight end. Just dropped it actually. That would have been a first down and possibly a touchdown as the Bulldogs finally do something wrong. That was Roderick Randolph. Their tight end was streaking right over the middle and he was wide open. And ball maybe had a little bit of heat on it. Couldn't hang on to it, but that was a big play that did not happen for the Bulldogs. They will attempt a field goal here, left hash mark. Going to be a 46-yard attempt here for Nick Carden. kick is up. It is long enough, and Carden is good again. A 46-yard field goal. So even when they don't score a touchdown, they bang through a 46-yard field goal by Carden. We'll step aside with 4:30 left here in the third. It's Alabama A&M 40, UAPB nothing. The Golden Lions will receive the kickoff when we return.
Hey, you.
Yeah, you. Getting that college education.
What are you gonna do?
Graduate and take some office job?
Be like everybody else?
Or will you dare do something different?
Like be a teacher.
Be my teacher.
Be my teacher.
You could be my teacher.
You got the skills.
The smarts.
Yes, you. You could be the teacher I never forget.
That'd be cool.
Does that corporate job even have recess?
We need more teachers.
We need more great teachers.
Teachers like you.
What are you gonna make of yourself?
What are you gonna make of me?
4 minutes, 30 seconds left. Here in the third, a little short pooch kick taken from the 18-yard line by Williams. Cuts it over, that's Peterson rather, stacked up at the 27. And that's about it. So the Golden Lions go back to work here. And long way to go and a short time to get there. Down 40 to nothing. 4:23 to go here in the third. Brandon Duncan back out there, ready. Three receivers to the right. They'll split it out five wide, two to the left here. No back set. Takes the snap. Rolls to his right, in trouble. He's got to throw it away. Has to throw it away. Just nobody back home to protect. Had to throw off his back foot. Keyshawn Williams checks in first time, I believe, at tailback spot here. And gonna throw it here. Gonna run it here. He's down. Just a gain of one. 4 minutes left here in the third. Drop back to throw it. Decided to run it last second, but only got maybe a yard. Got a third and about nine here. Third and nine. Under pressure, hit as he throws it. Flag down, gonna be pass interference. As Swain got tangled up with Mike Mills that time, but I don't know if it was a catchable ball or not as Brandon Duncan got hit as he threw it. They may talk about it, but it's gonna be pass interference unless they say it wasn't catchable. Go against Alabama A&M. Stops the clock at 3:32. So it'll be first and 10 for the Golden Lions here. as we get to the late portion of the third quarter here. Fast moving third quarter. Alabama A&M showing blitz. Nowhere to go with it, and again, just got to get rid of it. Throws it out of bounds. Seen a lot of that. Alabama A&M, this is the most we've seen a defense shut down this UAPB offense this season. Been a tough afternoon for the Golden Lions. Trailing 40-0 here, 3:27 to go in the third. Duncan set for the snap here on 2nd and 10. Going to throw it over the middle and caught at the 35. Down to the 28-yard line. First down, Golden Lions. Best pass play of the day, that's to Willie Young. A little post over the middle and found an open Willie Young, and Brandon Duncan threw a strike. And that's a little more familiar to what we've seen this season with Willie Young, and Brandon Duncan. Both of these guys have hooked up for a lot of big pass plays, along with Cody Swain. Swain's in motion now. And let's see what we got. We got another penalty flag comes in. This may be a false start. And it is. Clock stops, now it's rolling 2:50. Be first and 15 here. Two receivers right, it's Swain and Young to the right. Tight end Collins in motion from left to right. There's gonna be a little counter misdirection, handoff out of the shotgun to Montgomery, but he's eaten up in the backfield and loses about 5. Alabama A&M is just ready for everything today. They can do no wrong. See our TV side of things here, the big shadow, the press box part of the stadium casting out over the field, and that'll continue to get bigger throughout the rest of this game. A little slant to Swain, couldn't hold on to it. Mills got a hand in there and knocked it away. Falls incomplete, gonna bring up third down and about 20. Third and 20, four receivers set. Montgomery, the long back, gonna throw it here. Trying to dump it off to Montgomery, but overthrown. Had him, but again, some pressure coming in there. Tried to dump it off to him, led him too far. Incomplete, and Gillen's gonna come on to punt it away again. With 1:46 left here in the third. Standing back deep for the Bulldogs. Rashad Anderson back at about his own 10. End over end, trying to pin it in the 10, and nicely done at the 4. Great play on the other end of that kick by the Golden Lions was number 27, Isaiah Johnson, who got back there to make sure it didn't go into the end zone, and he dropped it dead at the 4. That's well executed, one of the better plays today on any part of the game for UAPB. So by far, this is the Bulldogs' worst field position, as they have started with pretty solid field position throughout the contest. So with 1:38 to play, here in the third, Alabama A&M leading UAPB by a score of 40-0. will operate inside their own five to start this drive. Ballard fakes the handoff. He'll keep it himself, and he's hit at the two-yard line, loses a couple of yards. Gold Lions got some good penetration in there. Gentrell Woodard got in there for the stop. They'll take the time as they get down close to a minute left here in the third. The Golden Lions are offsides here, going to crank it up deep up the right sideline and incomplete. Well covered there by Dave White, but it was a free ball there for Ballard. Offsides on UAPB will make it second down and about seven coming up here. Stops the clock at 59 seconds left here in the third. Handed off, this time straight ahead, getting up to about the 15-yard line was Brian Brower, a junior running back out of Montgomery, Alabama. And a first down for the Bulldogs. Take their time here. Play clock down to 10, 30 on the game clock here in the third. They'll snap it. Hand off Brower again, this time stacked up at the 15 and basically no gain on the play. And that will be the last play of the third quarter. So at the end of three, it is Alabama A&M 40, UAPB nothing as we head to the fourth quarter of this homecoming game between UAPB and Alabama A&M. Right back with the fourth quarter in just a moment.
So they say it's a man's world?
Well, I don't see anybody's name on it. While they were out doing their thing, we slowly changed all that. We changed all that! Today, women can do anything men can do. And there's one thing we're even better at.
Welcome back inside of Golden Lions Stadium here for homecoming 2016. As we start the fourth quarter of play here, Alabama A&M leading UAPB 40 to nothing. The Bulldogs have the football as we start the fourth quarter. Second down and 10 from the Bulldogs 16. Gonna run it, quarterback keeper. The 20 takes a shot, rolls to about the 21. Gain of about five on the play. For quarterback D'Angelo Ballard. Ballard has had a fantastic game for the Bulldogs. Now the team's operating out of the sunlight here on one end of the field, and they'll go into the shade on the other end. D'Angelo Ballard now right at 100 yards rushing for the game, along with Bentley. They have two 100-yard rushers little end around to McKenzie, and he's going to be eaten up and loses a couple. Tried to stretch it wide, a little end around to the receiver, Tevin McKenzie, but Golden Lions having none of that. Going to force just the second punt of the day for the Bulldogs. After three quarters of play, Alabama A&M, a total of 420 yards of offense, the Golden Lions 186. Bulldogs with 23 first downs for the Golden Lions 12. Outrushing UAPB 206-65. Maybe partially blocked here. A very short kick taken on a bounce by Roland at the 45, trying to go backwards to create some space, and there's nowhere to go to about the 44, and that's it. So the Golden Lions will take over first and 10. Third down conversions today, 4 of 7 for Alabama A&M. The Golden Lions just 1 of 9. Penalties have continued to hurt UAPB as well. 8 penalties for 68 yards, 5 for 44 for A&M. So we've had a lot of penalties both sides here today. There's a little bump there. That could have been a pass interference. They jumped the route on Willie Young. No call on the play. Pass incomplete, second down at 10. ...13-10 to play here in the fourth quarter. All Alabama A&M leading 40-0. Shotgun snap, Duncan got some time, now steps up in the pocket and is gonna be hit from the backside. Gains about a yard and that's it. Bring up third down and about 9. I think maybe 3rd and 8. Man in motion, that's Cody Swain, right to left. Shotgun snap, Duncan dials it up left, throws into triple coverage, incomplete. Nowhere to go for that football there to Willie Young. There's 3 Bulldogs emerged on the pass. But luckily that wasn't intercepted. So Gillen's back on to punt it away here. Style kick again. This time it's caught but then fumbled. Ball still loose, picked up by the Golden Lions. They're going to scoop and score, but I don't think they're going to blow it dead. You can't return a fumble off of a punt like that, I believe. I think the ball is going to be marked. Yeah, it's not a touchdown if they're going to mark it dead. It is not returnable off of a punt. So the band is playing, the cannon went off, but it is not a touchdown. The Golden Lions will have a first down at the 21. It was fumbled by Rashad Anderson, but at that point after he fumbles it, he cannot return it. It's at the point of the recovery of the fumble, even though he would have walked in for the touchdown. I believe that was Colby McNeil who scooped it up. But the Golden Lions have a good opportunity here, first down from the 21, maybe confusing some people on a play like that. It is confusing. Hand off left side of the 19-yard line is McDonald. Bring up second down at about 8. As the cannon went off, the band started playing the fight song, but it was not a touchdown, and that's happened many times before. It is a confusing play. But you cannot return, or you cannot advance a fumble after that on a punt, which is kind of a silly rule in my opinion, but it's a rule nevertheless. And cost UAPB a touchdown there. Rolling to his right, now throw back left. They got something set up here to Young at the 15, 10, 5, end zone. Yes, sir, touchdown, Golden Lions. Willie Young, and now we got a penalty flags all over the place over here on the UAPB sideline. We got several players pushing and shoving going on over here. I saw penalty flags being thrown all over the place. And it was way out of bounds near the UAPB cheerleading section. My gracious. There was a touchdown, it's good. And then all kinds of stuff happened way out of bounds up against the facade where the bleachers begin, right near the UAPB's cheerleading section. I don't know what happened, but it was a touchdown pass, 19 yards, and a screen set up to Willie Young. I do know that the Golden Lions are on the board. It's 40-6 now, and hate to see something ugly happen, but I'm not exactly sure what we have. It may be multiple penalties, but there were flags going up everywhere. So we had two personal fouls, one on each team. They offset, so the extra point coming up here. But it got a little ruckus over there on the sideline. I'm glad that fizzled out rather quietly, because I'm sure the cheerleading squad went scattering as they see these giant football players come invading their territory. Cleared out that whole area. Extra point coming up here for Gillen as the Gold Lions finally on the board here in the fourth quarter. Extra point is up and it's good. So we'll step aside. 11:26 to play. Here in the fourth is now Alabama A&M 40, UAPB 7. We'll have the kickoff coming up for you after this timeout.
Zap Zika by protecting babies and kids from mosquito bites. Here are some quick tips for using repellent. 1. Always follow the instructions on the label. 2. Don't use insect repellent on babies younger than 2 months old. 3. Don't use products with oil of lemon eucalyptus or paramethane diol on children younger than 3 years old. 4. Never spray insect repellent directly on a child's face. Instead, spray it on your hands and then apply, taking care to avoid the eyes and mouth. And 5. Use mosquito netting to cover carriers, strollers, and cribs. Check out more Zap Zika videos at cdc.gov/Zika.
Back inside Gold Lion Stadium. Get set for the kickoff. It's 40-7 now, our score. Gold Lions on the scoreboard for the first time. Took advantage of a fumbled punt by the Bulldogs, Rashad Anderson. Here's a little short kick taken at the 30-yard line, spinning off a man. As they're up back, running back stacked up at the 37-yard line, Brian Brower. Sponsors of Golden Lions Athletics this 2016 season, Arkansas Lottery, Brown Funeral Home, Coca-Cola, Energy, Nike, Reliance Bank, RJ's Grill, Russell Athletic, Sissy's Log Cabin, and Trotter Ford Lincoln, all proud sponsors of Golden Lion Athletics. ...11-19 to play in this one. Gotta keep it, throws it. Deep up the left sideline, caught on the sideline, but was he in? Out of bounds, incomplete. Ballard tried to connect with his big 6'4 receiver, Monte Jones, but he wasn't able to get a foot in bounds. Got a penalty flag on Alabama A&M, nevertheless, even if he did catch it, that'll back him up. With 11-12 left here in the fourth, Alabama A&M leading UAPB by a score of 40-7. Quarterback D'Angelo Ballard. He'll take the snap here. Jones breaks the tackle. Harris, rather, gets to the edge. Nice cutback. Shifty moves up to the 38. Pickup of about 6 on the play. Bring up second down and about 9 here. Harvey Harris. That last carry for the Bulldogs. He's just to the left of Ballard now. Clock will continue to roll, about 10 and a half minutes left. Play clock under 10. They'll keep working the clock here. Will the Bulldogs showing blitz off the edge, but a handoff straight ahead to Kevin Carter. First man in there, leave along with Willie Duncan. Short gain of just a couple. Bring up third down and about 6, maybe 7. Throw it. Now he's trying to get out of the pocket, not able to do so. Tashad Charity is going to pick up a sack. That'll bring up fourth down, and A&M will have to punt it away here. Just over 9 minutes to go. And partially blocked here. Golden Lions, I get this spinner at about the 43-yard line to get good field position. Coming in there, two players for the Golden Lions. That was Nick Williams. And Arius Offham getting a hand on that one. And .50 left, UAPB will take over here. Handoff, nice cutback. It's Keyshawn Williams. Again, look at him run, hard running. That's what he did as a freshman. You're gonna probably see a lot more of Keyshawn this second half of the season. He is just a bowling ball full of butcher knives coming at you right there. Fantastic running. Nobody wants to tackle that, right? I know I'm not trying to tackle that. 8:40 to go. They have flag down, and that's pretty much been two steps forward, three steps backwards, kind of the way it's been with the penalties this year for UAPB. But nevertheless, don't discount the hard running by Keyshawn Williams. But it is 40-7 all Alabama A&M as they're trying to, they'll spoil the homecoming game, but not homecoming altogether. It's been a great week of homecoming, and I know our crew between Hot 89.7, UAPB TV, and our Mass Communications, where we have been covering it all this week. If it's been happening, we've pretty much been there. High snap, gonna give it to Williams again. Again, just watch him go. This kid gets tripped up, but man, he has got something special about him. I'd like to see a lot more. I'm kind of sounding like a fan right now, but I'd like to see some more of Keyshawn Williams, sophomore from Dalloway, as he has shown signs and very fiery player, competitor. But he's got the rock twice and made something happen. He has to come out of the game there, kind of holding that left leg a little bit, maybe something he's been nursing. And you know the coaching staff sees his ability as there's a short gain on the handoff here on the next play. But if healthy, you're going to see Keyshawn get the ball more. And they have a stable of backs they've been rotating the football with. You can see Keyshawn over here on the sideline jumping up and down. He'll be trying to stretch that hamstring out or whatever he's battling over there. Third down and long here, third and 12. Handed off, it's Montgomery, and he's eaten up. Nowhere to go with it, tried to stretch it wide, taken down to the 39, and gonna bring up fourth down about 13, and Gillen's gonna have to punt it away again. Gillen will kick it away. Alabama A&M will get it. A little over. Boy, look at that high kick. Going back to get it. A fair catch caught at about the 15 by Rashad Anderson, who fumbled the last one. That's a good kick there by Gillen. He can get some good hang time on his kicks. That time he was able to really let one rip right there, and a nice kick. So 6:18 to play. Alabama A&M will take over. First down and 10. Leading UAPB by a score of 40-7. Quarterback coming into the game here for Alabama A&M. That's Damian May. First time we've seen him. Fakes the handoff in trouble, gets away from Charity. Now he's going to run it up the left side, forced out of bounds. Shows some quickness as he gets to about the 22 and escaped a sack back at about the 10-yard line and turned it into a nice gain. But he was in trouble there for a moment and made something out of nothing there. Gain of 7 on the play. Damian May, 5'10", 170 out of Biloxi, Mississippi. Gonna run it this time, straight ahead. First down yardage to the 30-yard line for the Bulldogs. Clock will continue to roll here when they set the chains, 5:40 and counting, as this game starts to wind down. But the Bulldogs put this one away in the first half. Jumped out to a 30-0 lead at halftime. Tacked on 10 more in the third quarter to make it 40-0 before UAPB cashed in for their first points about the 11-minute mark here in the fourth quarter. A very impressive showing by this Alabama A&M team here today. Got to give them a lot of credit. The Golden Lions have definitely had better games and made it easy at times on the Bulldogs. Short gain, first down carried to the 30. We got a man down for UAPB. Stop the clock with injury timeout with 4:54 left. Let's see who that is there. I believe that's number 94. Deshaun Hammond, freshman defensive tackle out of Arlington, Texas. And they able to get Mr. Hammond up, walks off on his own power. Good sign there. Some of the UAPB faithful in the crowd having fun. Still enjoying homecoming. Not going the way they want it to go on the field, but they'll still be having a good time and they'll still be partying all night long here in Pine Bluff tonight. A lot of alumni have come back. A big showing at homecoming here at Arkansas Pine Bluff yet again. 4:36 and counting as we resume play. Second down and 11 here for the Bulldogs. They have it at their own 29-yard line. Play clock down to 5. May fakes it, going to throw it. Flushed out of the pocket, going to keep it himself. Slides down at the 31. Only gets a couple out of it. Going to bring up 3rd and 9. Almost looked like a broken play as he kind of faked it and rolled back the opposite direction with it. And just kind of ran for his life and ended up picking a couple of yards up. That's about it. Timeout by A&M. I want to keep it here during this timeout and tell you about our great crew that we have on hand. And our crew here today, of course, back in the Hot 89.7 studios, and my ace back in the studio has been doing a great job for us. That's Miss Toriana Griffin. So big ups to her. Continues to do a great job each and every game day for us. And our crew here at the stadium for the UAPB TV sports side of things. Randy Kelly, Shelby Roby, Ingram, Christopher Gates, Andre Mitchell, Roger Robinson doing an awesome job. Of course, down the sidelines, those great shots brought to us here in a year out. Archie Howard, Jonathan Higginbottom, Jason Matthews here with us today, and of course, Miss Ariana Carmichael, who's directed the second half for us in the booth. And Jonathan Higginbottom also doing sideline shooting for us down there with during the second half, as I'm being told. Now, Roger Robinson is such a great videographer himself. He's also a great teacher and really gets his hands in there, and students get a great chance to learn from one of the best. And Jonathan's getting a chance to do that down there with Roger here this afternoon, so that's a good opportunity for Jonathan and all the mass communication students here doing a great job getting hands-on experience, and that's what it's all about. So wanted to definitely make that known as we are at the 324 mark. There's a shot of Jonathan and Roger down there. Jonathan with the camera on his shoulder, looking like a pro as he is. And he's got a pro's pro down there behind him and learning from the best in Roger Robinson. That's pretty awesome stuff. Clock at 3:22. Is the score. Alabama A&M, as the win and loss portion of the game is pretty much out of the question here, so they're going to sprint it here on 3rd and 20. Quarterback keeper May is hit hard, blasted there by number 44, John Tavis Testa. And Testa been tested a few times today, and he's answered the bell many times. Good-looking player is Testa out of Coral Gables, Florida, there in Miami. Unsportsmanlike conduct, though, is going to be on UAPB again. I'm getting tired of hearing that, for sure. Stops the clock at 3:10. Was to Shad Charity. That's his second unsportsmanlike penalty, so he's going to be ejected from the game. And as he talks it over with Monty Coleman on the sideline, first one I really didn't like. It was just kind of extra celebration after making a big play, but not sure what happened here on the second one. But either way, he's going to get an early shower. With 3:10 to go, that's automatic first down also. So the Bulldogs will have it, and Gold Lions may not get the football back. We'll see. May's going to keep it himself. Quarterback May gets up to about the 41. The clock is under 3 minutes now. Well, it doesn't get any easier next week. The Gold Lions will take on a very good Southern team in Baton Rouge. We'll have that one for you next Saturday, 4 p.m. kickoff. You can hear it right here on Hot 89.7. Handoff going nowhere, no gain on the play for the Bulldogs this time as the clock continues to melt down here, 2:20. The Gold Lions call a timeout. So they call a timeout. It'll be 3rd down and 4 coming up here in just a moment. But next two games, two of the best teams in the conferences, Southern and Grambling. They got them back to back coming up. Nobody feels sorry for you in this league, and just got to keep grinding and try to get better each snap, each practice, each day, each everything. Just try to get better. I know that's what Monty Coleman's preaching to his team, and trying to keep their heads up and keep fighting, keep grinding, and keep trying to get better. That's what you got to ask for your student athletes. That will be their MO, I'm sure, as of right now, and the way it should always be, and the way it is always. But it can be a tough, brutal league at times, and right now it is tough on the Golden Lions as they continue to try to get their scholarships up. Been a big theme this season and this week at homecoming, and raising money and trying to get scholarships up, something they've been striving for. And make a big difference. First down handoff for the Bulldogs. They'll continue to move the chains and the clock as it rolls here with 1:50 left. Here's the snap. Brower straight ahead, hard running. He bangs his way over the 45 up to the 44. Host of Golden Lions in there on the stop. Willie Duncan. Nobody plays harder and prepares better than he does. The epitome of a senior leader. One of the better linebackers to ever suit up for the Golden Lions here. Outstanding young man on and off the field. High character kind of guy that you love to have a whole bunch more just like him. Second down and two here. Handoff. Brower again. Just ground and pound. First down carry to the 41. Clock under a minute left as we put our final touches on this. Maybe a snap or two left, and that's going to do it for this one. Fast moving second half. The Golden Lions got in such a big hole there in that first half. It was still beautiful, sunny evening here as we approach close to the 5:30 hour, and should be a nice evening for homecoming festivities. So be careful out there, folks, as you celebrate and party tonight. Be careful. Have a good time. Make good decisions and enjoy yourself tonight here on this homecoming Saturday night. That is going to be our final play of the game, as this one is over. Final score, Alabama A&M 40, UAPB 7. As we wrap things up for our crew back in the studio, Hot 89.7 and our UAPB TV sports crew here. I am Tim Stubbs. Thanks for enduring my weak, sickened voice here today. Hope to be back normal for you next week. Make sure you tune in next week, 4 o'clock kickoff from Baton Rouge against Southern next Saturday. We'll have it for you right here. I'm Tim Stubbs saying so long again. Our final score, 40-7. Alabama A&M wins it over UAPB. Happy homecoming, folks. Enjoy yourselves this evening. Good night. Go Lions.